All right, everyone, weekly updates, let's get started. So you're going to cd into repos xscape. I can't type. Now, xscape here is the program I've been working on for a while now. I finally got keysim to be detected. So what is keysim real quick? Key codes. Well, those are the things that are hard bound to your keyboard, and they're listed 1 through 255. So the thing about keysim or key codes is each thing inside the key code here, the Y, the U, the I, the O, all this stuff past the equal sign is the keysim. So what is this? Well, this is just the thing that happens when you type. And you're saying, okay, well, why is there more than one instance of it? Well, you might figure out that this means shift on the second row, but there's actually sets of groups used in Xorg, and this is the first one. Most people only use the first one, but international keyboard users have the Alt key replaced with a special key called Alt-GR, or the ISO level 3 shift key, and this gives you access to the third set of characters. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to a cute here and type Alt-GR-A gives me the A with the thing over it, which is acute. So we have this, we have the first two, normal press and Alt-GR, which is the fifth and sixth press. So what is the third and fourth press then? Well, that's something called mode shift, and it's not bound by default on most keyboards, but it is easy to bind yourself. In my remaps file, I have that. I need to go here and go under my remap script. So what you do here is you can remap key codes to mode space, mode switch. I've mapped it to key code 65, which is the space bar. So when I hold space and do things, I will get results like this. ASDF is left and right bracket and left and right curly brace, which I have mapped here, as you can see. So okay, that's your rundown of mode shift and Alt GR real quick. Actually, the org server, if you're running an org server, has access to 16 different groups. And these are not accessible through hard keys. You have to actually run a program that will manually set them. And that is what I'm going to be working on, so you can access these other things, because I do not know of any program that actually does this right now. I looked around, didn't find anything, but I did find documentation on how to write programs like that. So anyways, now we know what key code is, we know what keysim is, and we know what Alt-GR and mode switch are to access six of the default keys on a key code. So let's talk about xscape now. xscape is the program I've been working on the last week or so. What xscape does is when you press a modifier key by itself, such as the super key, it will do an action on its own. I have mine mapped to escape so that I can press the Windows key to enter normal mode in Vim without having to reach all the way up to escape. So you can map this to other things. There are other modifier keys. There's shift, lock, control, mod 1 through 5, which are mapped to things like Alt L, mode switch, hyper L, super L. So you have these modifier keys that don't actually do anything on their own, like shift and the like. And some of these we want to remap to other things. However, it did it no matter what shift level you were pressing before. This has been fixed. The key code shift leveling group is now properly detected, or KSLAG, as how I have called it when I wrote the commit for this. Also, we're going to go over syntax. The big change to xscape is I made it to where if you type manually the key code itself in decimal, you can add a dash and put in 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, whatever you want, and this sets the keysys column, or shift leveling group. So 0 is here, 1 is here, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I forget if it's 1 index or 0 index. So yeah, it is 0 index. If you want to check out this version of xscape, then go ahead and go down to the link in the description. I will be linking my GitHub page where I've fixed that issue. It's still not perfect. I still have to figure out some issues, such as ISO level 3 shift currently does not work with it. If you press ISO level 3 shift and press the key, you still do not get a proper response from the program, and I don't currently know how to detect that. It is something I'm gonna have to look at, because in X event, it perfectly detects ISO level 3 shift or Alt-GR just fine, as you can see here. So I'm going to look into how that is detected, implement it that way, because the normal function that's supposed to detect keys doesn't actually work with that. X-Keyboard in the Xorg server does not recognize Alt-GR ISO level 3 shift and set the keyboard group level appropriately. And I have no idea why this is, because this is supposed to work when it gets the keyboard group state. So that's a problem. Also, if you're interested in looking at any of this code that has to do with the X-Keyboard extension for X-Keyboard, there is a ton of documentation here. I don't think anyone has had a really, really good look at this at any point in time, other than when the X-Keyboard functions were originally written. So I think using this to figure out stuff about all this is very good, because there's stuff like dead keys, locked modifiers, that could be used to some effect. And I plan to write a program or a set of programs that give you access to these things, such as setting dead keys, setting the group level, depending on running just a hotkey shortcut that you configure in like Simplex Hotkey Daemon or something like that. So that's what's going to happen next, and this is what I have done. I haven't really done that much else. It's just been reading a lot of documentation and filing some bug reports, as well as being busy with work. So that's really it for me for this video, guys. If you want to check out, again, the Xscape fixes that I brought on, you can do that down in the description. Also, you can only, at this current point in time, map modifiers to the first instance of a key code. Hello. Okay. So you can only map to the first instance. You cannot map to the second instance, because if you type key code 66 to super L and A, you will get capital A instead, because it doesn't remove the shift on it. So that is going to be something that is also, I'm going to have to make it to where it checks for shift, and if shift is active, it deactivates shifts when it prints the key, because it just sends the the normal key command. It does not actually, the shift is handled later than, it's handled outside the program. So I'm going to have to make it deactivate the shift until it's pressed again, so expect that to be fixed probably in the next week or so. But yeah, so that's enough for me, guys. If you like these videos, you know what to do. I'm not going to tell you what to do. Get in my Discord. You can ask me questions, have suggestions. I also read every comment, because I'm a tiny little YouTube channel still. Anyway, you guys have a great rest of your day, week, month, whatever. It's election time right now. Whatever the hell is going on. See you guys later.